Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you. Once again, first to you all, but importantly to all of the volunteers and supporters who have been there with me and for me in this campaign every single step of the way. It has been, to be quite honest, the honor of my life to serve as a Democratic nominee for governor of the great state of Florida, and to have for 21 months, competed all across the state of Florida in all kinds of areas of this state, including areas where people did not expect us to show up. Since the last time we spoke on election night, an evening where I operated with the best information that was available to me, and since that time, more information has come in. More information has become available around the votes that are still outstanding, and really for our need to ensure in this process that every vote be counted. What has changed in that period of time is something familiar to all of our press, which is we've learned in various parts of this state that there are still votes that are outstanding. There is even still in parts of this state some uncertainty around the total number of votes that are remaining to be cast. And you'll hear more about some of that from our lawyer, who will dig into a few more of those details. But I also have to say what has also changed since election night have been the chorus of voices from the President of the United States, the junior senator of the state of Florida, and the governor of the state of Florida, a chorus calling for the ending of the counting in this process. Now, what is their excuse for that? The best I could tell, I'm not sure. What I do know is that we don't just get the opportunity to stop counting votes because we don't like the direction in which the vote tally is heading. That is not democratic, and that certainly is not the American way. In America, we count every vote regardless of what the outcome may be. They've even used my own words on the evening of election night, in some cases, to justify ending the count. Well, let me say clearly, I am replacing my words of concession with an uncompromised and unapologetic call that we count every single vote, that we count every vote. And I say this recognizing that my fate in this may or may not change. What I do know is that every single Floridian who took time to go out to cast their vote, to participate in this process, deserve the comfort of knowing that in a democratic society and in this process, every vote will be counted. I've got to imagine that if the shoe were on the other foot of my opponents, not one of them would seek a different outcome. Not one of them would stand in the way of counting every vote. And I would ask them in this process, as it goes forward, that they stand in solidarity, all of us as candidates and as leaders in our own respective parties, to ensure that every vote be counted. The outcome of this election will have consequences beyond who wins and who loses. How we handle this election and this process will have reverberations for democracy for an entire generation of voters. You see, voter suppression is not only in a barricade or in a dog or in people blocking the entrances of a voting place. It's not even in a debate about what forms of ID are acceptable, hunter's licenses over a student identification card. But the truth is that voter suppression can show up in that first-time voter. The one who entered this process so enthusiastic and so excited about the ability to go out there and to participate in the democratic process, to let their voices be heard, only to hear their president, their governor, their United States senator throw out claims of unsubstantiated claims of fraud and calls and choruses to stop the counting of the votes. Voter intimidation also exists. And that hard-working man or woman who got up and, frankly, every day get up to go out there and work on somebody else's job in order to provide for a living for themselves and for their families, who either by convenience, by choice, or by necessity decided that they would complete a mail-in ballot to mail in that ballot, only to find that the W in their signature today didn't look like the W in their signature yesterday and had their votes thrown out. That's not a part of the American way, and that is not the democratic process that we have all come to know. We traveled all across this state in the primary and in the general process. We went to red areas, into blue areas, into purple areas of this state, and I fought hard for every single vote that we got. I fought hard even for the votes that I didn't get. And in this process, I am fully committed to seeing every one of those votes counted, whether they voted for me or whether they voted for my opponent, because that's what we do in a democratic process, in a democratic society. I'm determined in these next several days to use every opportunity within my power to ensure that there is a fair counting of every single vote. Today, a state-mandated machine recount will commence in the 67 counties all across the state of Florida. Our team has organized a cadre of hundreds of volunteers and lawyers to spread out all across the state of Florida to ensure to a fair and an accurate count in this process. Finally, I want folks to remember what this election is about. We're here because we want to make sure that the right that is guaranteed to all of us in our Constitution and certainly in our statutes is protected and that it is maintained. While this has obviously been a difficult election process for all of us who have run, this process is not over until every single vote is counted. To that end, I want to myself issue a call to my supporters and those who didn't support me, who may be supporters of other candidates, that the kind of violence and vitriol and bullying that we're seeing at some of these early precincts and these counting locations in Broward and in Palm Beach County and in other parts of the state, as these recounts commence, I would strongly urge that we all demonstrate the highest level of dignity and restraint. We can be for our candidates, we can be for our causes, without, in my opinion, resulting to moving toward any physical form of violence, using heated, racist rhetoric, or seeking to divide our communities any further than how we have already been divided. I am prepared to accept whatever the outcome is of this election, so long as every single vote in this process is counted. And to that end, our attorney, Barry Richard, who is here today, will answer some questions about the specifics along the way over the next couple of weeks that this process will take. I've got great, great, great confidence in attorney Barry Richard. He is someone who I know not only loves this state as much as I do, he loves this country as much as I do. And he is as committed a patriot and as committed to seeing every vote counted as we are. Finally, I just want to issue a final thank you. Over the next couple of days, I'll do everything within my power, and I will use my voice in ways that I think try to lift this debate, that attempts to raise us out of the tribalism that sometimes tends to take hold. I'll every day remind my supporters what this is about, and I think it's incumbent upon all of us, all the candidates who remain in this now recount process, that we will compel people toward our better angels as we do what is right and what is in the best interests of the people of our state and the people of our country, and that is to reassure hope in the democratic process, not to undermine it and certainly not to shred it. With that, I want to yield the podium to my attorney, Mr. Barry Richard.